What's the building going to do? It's going to change the world.
Location is extremely important.
One of the goals that the researchers had was to be in the middle of campus.
The building will bring about 2,000 people to operate in a central facility.
We got to take people from all over the campus and move their equipment and their people and their philosophies and their models.
There was no existing building where we could fit the technical requirements of that building into an existing building. So that's why we're building new next to the dome.
The building needs quiet. It needs vibration quiet, and it needs electromagnetic quiet. So we needed to look for a site that was far enough from the railroad track, far enough from the red line, and then the normal street traffic.
So we put monitors and sensors all over the campus, and the site next to Building 12 is the quietest for EMF and vibration.
It happened to be the highest performing site, and it's right in the heart of the main user groups, so it worked out perfectly. In terms of the program and the research, construction, it's a challenge, but we're up for it, so it's good.
The site criteria, there was the centrality, there was the quiet, and then we snuck in a third hidden condition, which was the most difficult site to build. There are only three ways you can bring a vehicle in, and two of the three have bridges at a height that's lower than most construction vehicles want.
There'll be trucks running every 20 or 30 minutes through that corridor, right past 20 or 30 departments who all look down onto the site.
It's the nucleus. It brings everybody together. Just about everybody that's in this surrounding area is going to be, in some level, utilizing the facility.
It's interesting to interview architects and planners as they pitch for work. They all sort of talk about the strength of MIT as the fact that departments and schools are all intermingled, and that there isn't a building for this department and a building for this department. It really creates some opportunities which wasn't in vogue for the longest period of time, and now with interdisciplinary research, it's sort of come full circle.
Roughly speaking, about 20% of MIT campus will be utilizing this facility. About the densest space of utilization anywhere in the United States.
In a little less than 3 years, I expect the researchers, I expect Vladimir to be in his Tyvek suit, doing whatever research he wants to be doing in 3 years, and broadcasting to the world that Nano is open for business.